Dear students, this is Vidya Mitra YouTube channel, Siddipet District. I am Nimma Raj Reddy, SMS, JPHS, Etikada Gestapo. Today, in arithmetic part, let us take up the ratio and proportion. In this, you are already familiar with the rational numbers, where fraction, and ratio. Let us discuss the difference among these three: ratio, fraction, and proportion. First of all, we know the rational number. If P, comma Q are integers, if P, comma Q are integers, P belongs to Q, Z, and Q also belongs to Z, and Q not equal to zero, then a number which in the form of P by Q is called a rational number. Next one is fraction. Next one is fraction. In this fraction, if A comma B are any two integers, A belongs to Z and B belongs to Z. Here B not equal to zero and B not equal to one. B not equal to 0 and B not equal to 1, a number which in the form of A by B is called fraction. Already you know the fractions are of three types: proper fraction, improper fraction, and mixed fraction. Proper fraction, improper fraction, mixed fraction. The fraction is in the form of A by B. If the numerator A less than B, the fraction is called proper. If the numerator A greater than B, the fraction is called improper. If the improper fraction is converted into an integer and a proper fraction, that is called a mixed fraction in the form of 1 and 2 by 3. 5 and 7 by 6, like that. So rational number is in the form of P by Q that may be converted into terminating decimal or non-terminating decimal. But here you have to remember Q not equal to zero. But in the case of fraction, denominator P, B not equal to 0 and B not equal to 1. That is fraction. Next one, ratio. So let us write. A rational number, if P and Q are integers, P an integer, Q also an integer, and Q not equal to 0. Then a number which in the form of P by Q is called rational number. A rational number can be written as either terminating decimal or non-terminating decimal. For examples, 1 by 6, minus 7 by 5, 3 by 4, 4 by 1, 0 by 2, 0 dash dash and so on. These are the rational numbers. Fraction. A comma B are any two integers, and B not equal to 0 and also B not equal to 1. In the case of rational number, Q may be, denominator may be equal to 1. But here in fraction, denominator should not be equal to 1. If denominator is equal to 1, that cannot become a fraction, that will become an integer like this. 0, 1, minus 8, 4, like this. Now, the fractions are 1 by 2, 3 by 2, minus 2 by 3, 1 by 7, minus 5 by 7, 7 by 5, so on. Fractions are of three types: proper fraction. If the numerators are less than the denominator, the numerator is less than the denominator, that fraction is called proper fraction. In the fraction, there are two terms. The number which is upside to this is called numerator, and this one is denominator. If the numerator is greater than the denominator, that fraction is called improper fraction. Improper fraction can be converted into a mixed fraction. In the mixed fraction, two parts are there: integral part and proper fraction, rational part. So 1 and 1/3, -2 and 5/7, 2 and 1/3, 4 and 6/7. So we can convert this into right. Suppose if I take 1 and 1/3. 1 is an integer, 1/3 is a proper fraction. We can convert this into improper fraction. 3 into 1 + 1/3. That is nothing but 4/3. 4/3 is an improper fraction. Suppose 2 and 1/3. 3 2s are 6 + 1. That is 7/3. So in the mixed fraction, integral part is there and decimal part is there, or fractional part is there. That is called mixed fraction. So every improper fraction can be written or converted into mixed fraction. Converted into mixed fraction. Next, come to our point, that is ratio. Ratio is nothing but the comparison. Ratio in our daily life, many times we may compare two quantities of same type. For example, Radha collected 50 flowers and Sita collected 40 flowers. We can say that Radha collected 10 flowers more than Sita. This is one way of comparison of taking difference. Another way, the cost of a car is 2,50,000 and the cost of motorbike is 50,000. If we compare these two costs of car and bike by difference method, the difference of the cost is 2 lakhs. The cost of car is 2 lakhs more than the cost of bike. But if you compare this by division, if you compare by the division, the cost of the car by the cost of the bike is equal to 5/1. So we can say that the cost of the car is 5 times the cost of the bike. So from the above two examples, in certain situations, comparing by division makes better sense than comparison by taking the difference. Now, comparison by division in the ratio. If the two things, of same units, if those are compared by division, that is called ratio. Comparison of things of same units by division is called ratio. That is denoted by A is to B or A to B. Ratio of two quantities A and B is A is to B, or that is denoted by A by B, or read as A to B. First quantity in the ratio is called antecedent, and the second quantity B is called the consequent. In A is to B, first one A is called antecedent, second one B is called consequent. Previously, if we write the fraction A by B, A is called numerator, B is called denominator. That is the difference. Now, ratio will be always in the form of lowest terms, in which terms has no common factors other than one. Those terms A and B should be, A and B should be always co-primes. Those should have no common factor other than one. Example one, Arna weight is 25 kgs and her father weight is 75 kgs. How many times father's weight is to Arna's weight? The ratio of the father's weight and Arna weight is 75/25. So if we simplify this into simplest form, 3/1. So father's weight is 3 times that of Arna. Father's weight is 3 times of Arna. Length of the pencil is 18 centimeters and length of its diameter is 8 millimeters. Students, here the length is in terms of centimeters and the breadth is in terms of 8 meters. In the definition itself, we know the comparison of two things or the comparison of things by division of same units. Same units means it is in centimeters, this will also should be in centimeters, or breadth is, diameter is 8 millimeters, so we need to convert this into millimeters, right? So if 1 centimeter is equal to 10 millimeters, so length is 180 and breadth is 8, the ratio of the diameter of the pencil to the its length is 8/180, 2/45, that is 2:45. So same ratio in different situations. Length of a room is 30 meters and its breadth is 20 meters. So length is to breadth of the room is equal to 3:2. Next. Two equivalent ratios, 6:4. If in the ratio, there are two terms, antecedent and consequent. If the two terms of a ratio are multiplied or divided by a constant k, the value of that ratio is unaltered. Antecedent and consequent are multiplied by a constant or divided by a constant, then the ratio is unaltered. These are called equivalent ratios. Therefore, we can get equivalent ratios by multiplying or dividing the numerator and denominator by the same number.